We are all years waiting to listen to Sri K. Parasaran, who has spent an eventful lifetime journeying along with the development of the Indian legal system itself. His experience is truly more than the age of the All India Bar, and now for a special benedictory address.
Namaste. Most respected scholar and judge, the Honorable Mr. Justice N. Kumar, the dignitaries on the dais, Mr. C.S. Vaidyanathan, Mr. Gurumurthy and Mr. Sundaresan, the dignitaries before me, my dear friend, Mr. Krishnamurthy, the Dean of the Madras Bar, the Ram Bhaktas, ladies and gentlemen, I am sure most of you must be looking at the watch. So working day, 6 o'clock we start, we have crossed 8, now we are in 8:15. Therefore, I have no right to keep you boring for a long time. Secondly, it is almost a Thanksgiving. Thirdly, I was able to argue the Ayodhya case, but words fail now. I am feeling emotional, and the overwhelming friends who have come here, when I see your flow of affection for me, words fail. I did not even realize I have to speak here, and whether to speak in English or in Tamil. I was listening to what all of them spoke. I was for a while thinking, but are they talking about somebody else or about me? Because on such occasions, you have to say something good about me. Sometimes you also have something more to it. But it is Providence which played its hands. Things are all predestined, and the entire universe dawns to the tune of one common piper. That common piper, Lord Ram, had to wait for 162 years to get this verdict. It is 1857-58, the Muslim rule failed. I am not saying that I don't want to go into the controversy, but one author of an Indian history, their book is not now available in the market, I was searching for it, but we had a textbook in the fifth form or SSLC by a Bengali author. He wrote the reasons for the fall of the Mughal Empire: bribery, corruption, intrigues, rebellion, intolerant religious policy, imposition of unjust taxes like jizya, and the wars of succession led to the fall of the British Empire. Led to the fall of the Mughal Empire. This is what he wrote. Then the conqueror put up the mosque, and the prince said, Babur the conqueror constructed the mosque. Then came the British rule, 1857-58. Before that, the East India Company came. None of us knew that they were an alias for the British crown itself. We come to know of it in 1858, when the Government of India Act was passed by the British government in 1858. There it recites that the company was holding it in trust for Her Majesty. So, it was a story of camel and the Arab, first evicting the saint in the house, and then the camel getting fully into it. So, they had played a devious method, had somebody sent already as their trustees, then came to power and then took it over. But they are wise people, therefore they believed in divide and rule, and which is still persisting, while our culture is a composite culture of a pluralistic society where all of us must learn to live together in harmony and continue to live together forever. That's why Bharatiyar said, Uru Thayin Vayitril Pirandhom Nam Sandai Seidhalum Sahodharanru. That cordiality has to come as soon as possible. When I landed at the airport, one of the colleagues who assisted me in the case had come to the airport to take me to the airport because there was some problem, one photograph had been prolongated, and there were also some problems. So a police people had also come to take us there. That friend asked me, what do you expect? I didn't think. It was an instantaneous, instinctive reaction. I said, Lord Ram never sends away anybody empty-handed. I wonder later why I said it, how I said it, did I at all say it? First suit was filed by a Hindu worshipper. The court held, you have got a right to worship, subject to law and order. The authorities who have got orders to pass for law and order, and subject to authorities who orders who want to maintain an orderly worship in the temple. Subject to these two conditions, his right to worship was upheld. Next came suit 3, the Nirmohi Akaras suit. Their writers negatived, saying their suit is bought by limitation. Still, the court held that in the trust board or committee or whatever a board is going to be constituted, the Nirmohi Akara should have one representation. They got relief. Then came the suit filed by the Muslims on behalf of all the Muslims in a representative capacity against the Hindus, on behalf of all the Hindus in their representative capacity. While the court held Nirmohi Akara's suit was barred by limitation under Article 120 after 6 years. In the case of the suits filed by Muslims, the court said, to this suit, Article 142 of the Limitation Act of 1908 applies, which gives 12 years, therefore their suit is not barred. First came to the rescue of the Supreme, to the in favor of the plaintiffs, then the suit filed by Muslims, remember, is Article 142 of the Schedule to the Limitation Act. Then the court said, we must mold the relief. Therefore, we exercise powers under Article 142 of the Constitution. From Limitation Act, Schedule 142, they went to Constitution 142. And they said, we have to do complete justice. Therefore, they will have 5 acres of land. The suit property is only 2.7 and odd. But they will get 5 acres of land, either which the central government should give from the acquired properties, which is 65 acres, or the state government should give some other property of the state, but in a prominent place at Ayodhya. So the Muslims who filed a suit got relief. And the Hindus did not file a suit because there were already defendants in the Muslim suit. But Lord himself filed the suit. First plaintiff, Ram Lalla, the minor. The second plaintiff, the place, that is Janmabhoomi itself as the plaintiff. And the third plaintiff was the next friend or guardian of these two, because an idol or a place cannot come and sue. The court held the property belongs to Lord Ram. The fight was between two worshippers, saying it's a title suit by the plaintiffs, and they both were claiming only right to worship. But it became a title suit in the Supreme Court arguments. The Lord's title was upheld. Not only that, now further relief is an injunction not to cause obstruction from constructing new temple in the said place. Is it the hand of any human being which can so mold the relief? It is the hand of Lord Ram himself. He waited for 69 years. The suit was filed. One was filed before coming into force of the Constitution, about 1 week or so before the Constitution came into force. Another suit was filed after the Constitution came into force. 69 years, 70th year running. I became a lawyer in 1950 after the Constitution. 69 years done, 70th year. And the Supreme Court invoked Article 162 of the Limitation Act, added 167. Article 162, 1 plus 6, 7. Article 162, is it not? It resorted to, I'm sorry, Article 142. This is a problem of vanishing memory at this age. Supreme Court in Article 142 of the Constitution and Article 142 of the Liberation Act. I was wondering why my calculation of time going correct. 142, if it now would be all right, Article 142 of the Constitution and 142 of the Schedule to the Limitation Act of 1908. 1 plus 4, 5. 5 plus 2, 7. Seventh avatar is that of Lord Ram. Is it the hand of man? It is not the hand of man. It's the hand of God. And then I was pleasantly surprised when I read the print drafted by my predecessor, one of the most intelligent and most brilliant lawyers in the country at that time. He was chosen and invited as Solicitor General, but no other person than who was leftist who became a congressperson, Mohan Kumar Mangalam, after seeing his performance in the Supreme Court. He had drafted the plaint. One of the allegations made in the plaint is the Muslims are also children of God. Just as Ram is for us, Allah is for them. Just as temple is for us, mosque is for them. He said they are also children of God. But the temple cannot be shifted because birthplace cannot be shifted. If on Ram's birthplace you build a mosque, it is still his birthplace. If you build a church, if you ask where is Ram born, we'll say only there. That does not change the birthplace. Therefore, we can't change the birthplace. Therefore, temple has to come there. But in certain circumstances, they're very careful. You must not say always. In certain circumstances, a mosque can be shifted to another place. And this is such case. Please let them shift it to another place. You see the plaint allegations? Therefore, not a confrontational plaint, but a very molded relief for all. And that is what has happened in the case. And Lord Ram thought, one attorney general after he laid his office, let him draft the plaint. His successor, I was sixth attorney general. So the successor attorney general, who is no longer the attorney general, argue my case. Did I choose the brief? I was very hesitant because I was worried, will I be able to read the entire case for nearly 14,000 pages of documents and oral evidence. 4,400 pages of the judgment of the Allahabad High Court. I knew my limitations. One must know his limitations first before he knows his capacity. I said I will lay the foundation. I will address the questions of law and give a picture of the case. But the points which I make, the evidence has to be correlated. And that the lawyer who is most competent, as good as myself or even may even do better, is C.S. Vaidyanathan. And I'm glad he referred to my very good friend. We have been friends for a long number of years, even when he was practicing in Madras High Court, Mr. K.K. Venugopal. I'm so happy he referred to me. We have been such close friends. He has also made a remarkable contribution. He had trained a lot of juniors who have become High Court judges. I had trained at least 40 or 50 juniors in my chamber. But anybody comes, I will not ask him, from which place in this country you come, to what caste you belong. These two questions I have never put. Because what did the print, Ram's print says, all of us are children of God. That's what the great patriot Bharatiyar said. That is the way to live our life. That's the lesson which Ram has given us. And I'm happy at the way I'm looking at it. I never knew my daughter is going to say something here. The Shastras are not only very good in their educational field, one of the most fantastic universities, and today it is one of the most outstanding universities. Not only inculcating in everyone knowledge, education, but also ethical values. If ethical values are there, that country will prosper. Those students are a class by themselves. They will become top people in their life. and I'm grateful to them for the first organ. First, we had a good function at Ayodhya. Mr. Vaidyanathan was also there. This is the, at Chennai, this is the first occasion where the Shastra University has occurred. What is more, Ram is not an exclusive monopoly of either Tamil Nadu or UP. Tamil man appeared or UP. Karnataka is here. And he's one of the great scholars. He's not a mere a judge. He's a great scholar. He's one of the outstanding judges. And he has come all the way from Karnataka to be a part of this participation. And another coincidence, Mr. Vaidyanathan's family were very close friends of our family. Whenever I come from Delhi to Madras, first question which my wife will put is, how is Radha, his wife? So, first important is the wife, the husband comes second. She is the better half, and the opposite is the worse half. Valmiki did not say, it is the story of anybody. Tulsi said, Ramcharitamanas. Valmiki said, Ramayana. But inside he says, Sitaya Charitam Mahat. If you say, is it a Charitam? It's a Mahat Charitam of Sita. But title which I will give is Ramayana. You say, see something, Sanskrit is a wonderful language, but it is at the quarters, it is hated. One need not hate any Sanskrit, any language. All languages, especially to the extent possible, one must learn. And Ravana means Rama Ayana. That Ma and Ha, when they join, will become Ma, Rama Ayana. The path on which Lord Ram stood steadfast and walked. That is the path of Dharma. Satyatma, Dharma Sandhasche, Yemo Dasaratriyati is what Lakshmana says. Satyasandha is Dharmatma. Therefore, this is Ramayana. Now, the name Ram is important. There again, he is not one which is diverse, which unifies. All of us are one. That is, to the word Ashtaksharam and Panjaksharam are merged into one and name Ram was given. Because Vasishtha gave the name. Vasishtha is no ordinary rishi. It's an extraordinary rishi. And there also you see, the importance is the wife, the lady. There are so many rishis. She is chosen. Arundhati is chosen as the model. About Sita, Hanuman says, Kamban says, Karpanam, Puruladundram, Palinadam, Puriyakandain. He did not say, I saw a lady of chastity. He said, I saw chastity itself. That's what Hanuman tells Rama. He says, Bhartri Vatsalya Bhushanam. When I first saw her, I saw only one jewel. Nothing else was visible to me. And that is Bhartri Vatsalya Bhushanam. That is, in one's life, there is two things are important. Iham and Param. For Iham is, we call Shittinbam. For Aham, we call it Perinbam. The Sanskrit saying is, for both, what you require is Antakarana attachment. For married lives, Antakarana Tattvasya, Dampatyo Snehasayamayat, Ananda Karandire Koyam, Apatimiti Giyate. It starts with Antakarana. I have left the link, I'll come back to it. Rama. Next is the Perinbam. There, Adi Shankara says in Sivananda Lagiri, Guhayam, Geheva, Bahirapi, Vane, Vajrasikare, Jaleva, Vannava, Vasatehe Kim Vadapalam, Sada, Yaseva, Antakarnamapi, Shambho Tavapade, Antakarnamapi, Shambho Tavapade, Chitam Chet, Yogasu, such a Paramayogi, such a Sukhi. And now I come to Ramayana, Rama. Ra, I said, Ra is the most important letter which gives life to the word Narayana. If you take away that Ra, it becomes Naayana. That is pathless, radarless. Naayana. Similarly, Namashivaya, Panjaksharam. The word which gives life to it is Ma. If you take out Ma, Na Shivaya, no Shiva. So he took the Ra and Ma and put Rama. Don't fight, I'm a Veera Vaishnava. Don't fight, I'm a Veera Saiva. Or don't fight, I am a Muruga Bhakta. I told Vaidyanathan, he will vouch for it. When we were asked to file the suggestions for to molding the relief in the case. He said, really for the court, not for the lawyers. I said, I'm not good. You will do it better. He sent me 3 pages. I said, one more para is necessary, Mr. Vaidyanathan. He asked me, what is this paragraph? I said, Senaninam Aham Skanda is what Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita. Among the commander-in-chief, I am Muruga or Skanda or Subramanya, he says. So finish that with this so that the commander will ensure that we win the battle. I take no credit for the performance which I did. It's all God made. One thing I must acknowledge, that I am coming to. That is, my felicitations to Vaidyanathan. This should have been an occasion, we should say felicitations to Parasaran and Vaidyanathan. But therefore, I now play the role of a person who is offering felicitations. He did such a remarkable work. But then when you deal only with the evidence, mass of evidence, that will not be projected. Law, you can play as you like. So, he handled the evidence very well. But he has one advantage over me. I've got a very old phone. I can only receive calls and I can give outgoing calls. At least these two I know. I don't have this WhatsApp. I don't use a laptop. All those things I don't have. But God took care of me. But he has that advantage. So, he scored better than me. Secondly, this archaeological evidence played an important role. And I left it exclusively to him. I did not read the evidence about archaeology, nor the judgment of the High Court. He held a conference at Coimbatore where we go for this treatment. Arya Vaidyasala. He was there. Mr. Yogeshwaran came there. And Yogesh was instructing him, and probably some of the experts also came. And he made a masterly presentation of the archaeological report. But in all other respects, I had also read the evidence, entire evidence, because that Yogesh will not leave me unless I read. I had read the case for 1 year, and 8 months we were together. Reading. Every line of the entire materials I had also read. I told the court also. So one of it came to my rescue when I was concluding. So I said, not one of the witnesses was put a question in cross-examination that as to whether there was a labor room in Dasaratha's house. Then I asked Vaidyanathan, I suppose I am correct. Yes, you said witness says it. The judges were surprised and shocked for such a question put. Then I told them, yes, my lord, Babur was the great emperor, but Dasaratha was a beggar. He could not afford a room, a labor room. Only he could afford a palace to Kausalya, another palace to Kaikeyi, and 4 palaces as bungalow for the 4 sons. This, you see, this came in handy for me because I had read the evidence. But luckily, to confirm its correctness, he was sitting by my side, he had read the entire evidence. I am saying not to boast about our arguments. See how somebody who's fully read the evidence, that gives confidence. So am I right or wrong? I could verify. So I extend my felicitations to him. The Mahārāmāyaṇa, it was Dasaratha who is the father of Ram. Dasaratha. Rama had to fight Dasanana, the 10-headed monster. I had a team of 10 lawyers with me. This again is a coincidence. After Vaidyanathan comes Yogeshwaran, he puts his name last, P.V. Yogeshwaran. The gentleman knows every word in these 14,000 pages of evidence. He knew every word in the judgment of 3 bound volumes of 4,400 pages. The moment you ask him, he need not go to the laptop. You just try to turn a few pages and locate it and tell you. And I had one Ranjit Kumar, who was former Solicitor General, P.S. Narasimha, who was also former National Solicitor General, whose father was a High Court judge, Kodan Ramayya. He was a devotee of Ram. He has written 3 or 4 books on Ram. One of the books I wrote a foreword, and also I participated in the release function. Then we had Bhakti Vardhan Singh. They follow the Bhaktivedanta Prabhu. Therefore, that's his name. He was also very thorough with the facts of the case. Then this was Ashwin Kumar, who is a chamber junior of my son Mohan Parasaran, and I misappropriated him for my use. He's a brilliant fellow. There's another junior devotee with one girl. She's too brilliant. She is Atithi Dani. And that's Darsimha's junior, Sridhar Potaraju. This team was there. So I'll say, please look up this case, please take that case, please take this case. Immediately, whatever I want, they will get it. We had no problem. Whenever in Sanskrit I had to verify anything, this Narasimha is a real scholar. And occasionally I felt, is it a family function? Because the sastras don't discuss with anything. They fix his function only discussing with Mohan and Satish, as if I have given a vakalat to them to appear for him. I have not given any vakalat for them. Therefore, please deal with me directly. So I was surprised when she came here. Not only that, about Vaidyanathan, I told you the family relationship, the attachment to his family, and how when I come from Delhi, even if I had not met Vaidyanathan, I would tell her, yes, I met Vaidyanathan, I also saw Radha, they are all right. Otherwise, I will not have the next coffee in the house. And Sundaresan, he himself said that my father had appeared for them, but his mother and my wife were very good friends. Very frequently, she used to visit, and they used to spend some time in the house. Therefore, I was wondering. And Gurumurthy is all pervasive. And he is now carrying on Tughlaq. You can understand. This is that to maintain the tradition, the fearless Cho in succession. It is a very peculiar combination of people, all ordained by him. I think I wanted to finish earlier. I have taken more time than I should. On a working day at 8:30, I thank you for the love and affection which has prompted you to come here, this function, and participate. I don't know how to answer you. I am charged with emotion, and your overflowing love and affection submerges me to that. I am deeply grateful to Lord Ram. One thing I forgot to tell you. Judgment was delivered on Saturday. On Monday night, 8:45, at Delhi, in the residence in which I am, above the second floor in the open terrace, about 30 or 40 monkeys came. Can't imagine so many monkeys, and that too night at 8:45. Therefore, and they were playing, mirth, jumping, kicking. The next house construction is going on. They won't kick the tin which is covered throughout to avoid any pollution. There is a drumstick tree in the service lane. They broke almost all the branches of the tree. It's almost as a tree now standing with only one or two branches. The hand of God has played. Lord Ram has taken care of it. 69 years he waited for it. From 1950, for 69 years he had waited for it. When he came as avatar, only 14 years of Vanavasa, and in Parnasala life, 14 years. He lived in a Parnasala. Now it is 20 years after the demolition, 29th year. Twice that time he has been in Parnasala. He had waited enough. His patience gave way. He said, enough is enough. Your temple shall come. I profusely thank every one of you. I thank Mr. Niranjan Judge, who has come, Mr. N. Kumar, who has come all the way from Bangalore to participate in this function. I must also thank the Shastra University, which has a partiality for me. So don't take them seriously. So they also, they not only praise me, they also arrange such persons who out of their kindness and affection will only talk highly about me. There are minus points. Nobody is a perfect person. If there are no defects, you cease to be human, because God alone is defectless. That's what Sita says, Nakashin Naparadyate. Is there one in your creation who is not a sinner? She asks the Lord. She tells Hanuman, when he wants to taunt to the Rakshasis who harassed her, he says, I thought you were a brilliant fellow. I never thought you were such a fool. Nakachin Naparadyate, she says. There's nobody who has not committed some sin. Every saint had a past, every sinner has a future, is what she says. Shakespeare said, use every man into his desert, who shall escape a weeping? Therefore, it is not because of any virtues of anyone. Anyway, out of great love and affection for me, you have discovered so much praise on me. I'm grateful to every one of you. Namasadase, asadas, you may bless me irrespective of my age. I seek your blessings. Thank you for your patience. Jai.